back here at Fugate Gymnasium as the Jets hold on and they win the game over Rogers State. Final score 76-64. We're joined by head coach Darin Spence here. Well, coach, ahead by 23, kind of felt like this was going to be a get everybody in the game sort of a night. And as you've mentioned, your frustrations throughout the year kind of go away from what we're trying to force some things. But at the end of the day, you made some free throws down the stretch and you hold on for the win.
We did. And once again, I got to put a plug in for the wrestling event coming on the 19th.
Sure.
After our Saturday home game at 1:30, people. So the wrestling on Sunday, let's all get there. But, you know, I think what's lost in all of this is the dang stretch that we just went through. Four games, two on the road, tough games, and then I'm not going to move any – I don't want to move Thursday games to Wednesdays anymore. Thinking we're getting an extra day for the Saturday game, especially when we come off that four in a row.
Yeah.
Because we got one less day. And that's not smart. So we got to do a better job. So good first half. Thought we came out with good energy. And then third, when halftime came, that wasn't our friend. I thought then we just kind of got heavy-legged. And we got tired. We got fatigued. And then found a way to make some mistakes. But like you said, we pulled it together, fought off their run, and made some free throws.
Yeah, you know, talk about finishing the games. And I thought several players stood out. You had Abby George stepping up today. Birnbaum had a great night on the backboards. And then, Faith Mason Vessel finally getting it going offensively. She was, 4 for 4? And
right.
Hopefully she's got some confidence going into the next couple games.
Yeah, it's exactly right. It can't always be Caitlin Potter. You know, we've seen the 30-point and then the 2-point the next game. Or we've seen that. And that's just a fatigue level on her, which is what we talked about after the last trip. We've got to get in that weight room. We got to get stronger because this league is just a muscle league and it's bigger bodies. And, you know, Rogers State came from the Heartland. So we're both okay in that league. There's a few good teams. But up here in the MIAA, it's just a whole different game. And so the wear down factor, it's real. And it's a mental grind as well. So you're going to have more players. So, yeah, Faith, you know, that was Faith. You know, we thought, well, I just made the decision that I'm not going to play her a bunch of minutes. And if it takes her the rest of the year, and if that makes her mad and maybe makes her work harder in practice, I don't care at this point. We've got to put ourselves in a position. We want to get in the top 10 and make the conference tournament. And so we've got to win some more of the games. And, of course, this one and then Saturday's game are ones that we have to take care of. So, but Abby George stepped up big.
She did.
I've liked her demeanor in the last so many practices that we've had, and she's kind of shaking things off, and it's just getting, but that's what she should be doing all the time, right? And that's what's frustrating about it. When we had her and Faith together going well last year, we were much, much better. And so, we still got time. Faith's still going to keep coming, some confidence. She's not the most energetic kid. You're not going to look at her, and she's not that kid if you're giving a speech you want to look at for motivation during the speech. But that's her, kind of stoic. But she's got some nice power moves, some good quickness, and it's taking some time, but it's nice to see that out of her for sure.
Well, you say that it can't be Caitlin Potter every night, but here recently it has been. 27 points tonight, 6 3-pointers, and now in MIAA play, she's averaging over 20 points per game in conference, and she's gone over 20 points now in 4 straight games and 5 of her last 6. So
wow.
You say she can't do it, but it looks like she wants to try, Coach.
Well, yeah, because that's her. And we talk a lot about the competitiveness of kids these days. Now, Caitlin Potter has it.
Yeah, she does.
If you could get that to some of our others, she is a competitive sucker. And, of course, I'm joking with her, and I said, you missed that last free throw so you wouldn't come out again. I said, that would have been cute when you were 10 at the rec league in Arc City, but not here. She gets it. She handles things really well. She takes a good chewing.
She does.
But she bounces back. She bounces back with that mentality of, oh, I'll show you, coach. Kind of like when I was in college and I played for a guy named Dan Pratt. And he was nose to nose with me all the time because he knew I would, all right, I'll get you. You know, I'll show you.
You nose to nose with a coach, I can't imagine.
Yeah. But he knew I would go knock somebody down, that kind of a thing. I wasn't going to go drill shots like her.
Right.
You know, but she's a special kid, and we better enjoy her the rest of the way for sure.
Yeah, talk about Saturday's game, your next opponent, and what are you guys going to do to prepare for them? Like I said, all games coming up are important. Yeah. Let's talk about Saturday's contest.
I mean, Northeastern State against the Riverhawks, a six-point loss for Newman down at Tahlequah in their first ever road trip.
Right, and it's a game that we feel we gave away.
Sure.
We started very poorly.
Yeah.
You know, the first game, league game, and we just didn't handle it right. Their band kicked in, their football guys. But we had a lead, and we just didn't handle it right. And so hopefully that's in the back of our minds when we talk about it, prepare. We probably won't do anything tomorrow. We got to take tomorrow off, because if we can't get it back on Friday to play Saturday, then there's bigger problems, right?
Sure.
I think a lot of times now that the days that you take off are more important than trying to get back in there. And I think that's old coach versus young new coach. Maybe when I was a 27-year-old head coach, I would have been right back in. You son of a guns, you missed this. You know, but you put that win in the win column and you move on and prepare. So we know they have two shooters. We know they have two good shooters. And so we've got to we just got to find them better. They probably play a lot like this team tonight, where they're not going to post up a lot. They're going to kind of cut through things, cut people through the lane. So we just have to do a good job of identifying where those two kids are, and their names escape me, but and of course rebound on long shots.
Darin Spence, head coach for the Jets. They win it here today over Roger State. Coach, congratulations.
Appreciate it. Thank you, guys.